Guys, welcome back to BC Bricks, and today I will be showing you how to make custom visors for Phase 1 and Phase 2 LEGO Clone Troopers out of paper. Yeah, you heard me. You can make these out of paper, and it's super easy once you get the hang of it. They look like these. So, yep, made of paper, these visors, and you can use them on Phase 1 or Phase 2 Clone Troopers, and I found this technique very helpful once you get the hang of it. And, yeah, let's get into it. So, for materials, all you'll need is a glue stick. It can just be one of those really cheap ones, just a glue stick. A marker for whatever color you want your visor to be. Sorry about that. You'll also want some scissors. You'll want an eraser. And of course you'll want a pencil. And then also you want some paper. Now I would suggest, it doesn't have to be new paper, like this one I've been using for a long time, as you can see all the like the cuts and stuff, but I would suggest it be relatively durable, but it's like this, like it shouldn't be construction paper, but it shouldn't be like leaf paper either. Now first up, I've already drew the design, but this is about the design you would want to draw for your visor, just this part. And, once you're done drawing that, all you have to do is just color it in with whatever color you want it to be. So I'll go ahead and do that. So guys, once you're done coloring it, it should look something like this. But before I go any further, if you are enjoying this tutorial or you are already done with it and you really like it, then please consider subscribing and don't forget to like and comment below your thoughts. It would really help the channel a lot. So, also side note, you will also want to like color in the back around where the visor is. That way, the inside and the outside is colored in. What I mean is, like this. Now, you don't really need a color, you just need to like color in like the general area where the visor is, if you understand what I'm saying. That way it looks better. Like, you see the inside here is also colored as well as the outside. And now all you need to do is cut that out, and I'm gonna go do that right now. So once you're done cutting it out, it should look something like this. Now don't let the background fool you. I changed it because I had to film it somewhere else, but as you can see, it should look like this. And then what you're just gonna do is you're gonna have to fold it right about there. So it should look like that. So I just folded it in. And then you're gonna do it on both sides. I'm sorry if my hands are kind of covering a bit, but what I did is I just folded it in like that, like so. And then you're basically just gonna glue it onto the helmet. Now, this does not cause any damage to the Lego piece. You can just take it off anytime you want, and it won't damage it. The marker might kind of fall out a little bit, but that can easily be removed if you do use like a washable marker. I will note though, if you like for this one, I can take it off and the helmet won't be damaged, but the visor might kind of be worn. So I wouldn't suggest taking it off unless you didn't want to use it anymore. But here's the visor, and I'll glue that onto the helmet that I want to glue it onto. So when gluing the visor on, as you can see here, you'll want to glue it on right here about. And I'm just going to take a glue stick, and this might take a little fidgeting around with, but all you really to do is apply some glue to this, the little part that's sticking out. And then I want to put it on this clone trooper because I'm trying to make a Commander Cody, and I'll show you once it is reasonably well applied. So once you put it on there, you want to hold it for a while, let it kind of dry. So you want to press it down a little, and it might seem fragile at first, and you might actually need to like make some adjustments. It's a little fidgety, but then you'll do that to the other side, hold it down, and after a little while it should be good. So I'll let it sit for a while and glue it some more, glue it on completely, and then we'll come back. So after a while, I finally got the visor on. If you're doing this, you might realize it's actually pretty hard sometimes, and depending on the type of glue you're using, it might like not stick well, and you might have to do it multiple times. But once you do get it, it looks pretty good, and personally, I kind of made the visor a little too long, so once you put it on, you can snip it a little, and I would suggest like pushing this part down to get the visor effect to look like this. And yeah, if you have any further questions on how to do this, comment below and I'll be happy to help you further. And yeah, so here's how you make your custom visors completely out of paper. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this quick tutorial.